morning everyone. So this lecture is about one of the topic which is most of the times asked in the question in the gate, that is a shear center. This is actually a very interesting topic, shear center. So if you know the concept of strength of material of shear stresses and bending stresses properly, then just the application of that is in this shear center. And there are many in the scene that whenever you wash the truck below, the chassis is made up of C sections, right? And how the load is where the load application on that C center, how it is away from that wave, okay? That thing we will see in where the shear center is the point where we are applying the load so that there will not be any. There will not be any twisting. Only the beam under loaded is only bends, pure bends, not twist. Because see, twisting is very dangerous. If part twisted, right, then it is very easy weak in failure, right? So easily fails. That's why we avoid the part to twisting. Instead, yes, bending is very and bending sometimes. From with the help of the bending, you can add the strength in the part also. So bending is not that much severe in case of design of C-sections beams, right? We will see in this slide one by one. Okay, so today's topic is shear center. Okay, from the strength of materials. Now see, this is a shear section, right? So in this C section, where to apply the load so that there will not be twist on this beam, there will be only pure bending. That thing we are going to see. Okay, so this is a very important concept. Most of the students ask me to explain these concepts. Okay, so I request you to just focus on the each and every concept and watch the lecture till end. See, I am not forcing you, but if you are interested, you watch till end. Okay, so. Let us consider the rectangle section. See, in this, there will not be, in case of rectangle section, the shear center will be this point G. This will be the point G, that is the center of gravity of this cross section, right? This is a G. Okay, here will be the shear center, right? So this is a center of gravity or centroid, you can say centroid from the cross section, right? So these sections are have double symmetry, means these are the principal central axis. This is X, right, and this is Y. So these are the principal central axis. So if you fold along this axis, this will be, you will get symmetry, right? So it will exactly match this profile on this. Again, along X axis, if you fold like this, then again you will get symmetry here also. The same case is in case of circle also, right? So this is the X axis and this is the Y axis. These are the two principal centroidal axis. Whenever you get fold, and here the G, right? That is a center of gravity will be here, right? So this is a CG or center of gravity, means here the load, you can see what this G means, right? Actually my pen is not getting correct over there, not able to mark a point, it's going okay. See, whenever you apply the load here, right, along this Y axis, right, like this, the load will pass through this center of gravity, right? You can apply the load like this also. There will be only bending of the part, right? There will not be any twisting. See, now these two have double axis of symmetry, right? Along this principal central axis. Now we will take a C sections. See, for C section, okay, the XX axis will be the axis of symmetry, but whenever you get fold on this along this principal central axis, that is YY axis, you won't get the symmetry, right? So in C section, this section has only one axis of symmetry, right? So we have to see this is how the shear center come locate for these sections, where exactly the shear center locates. In detail we will see, right? So even though, see, for the L section there will not be both. See, suppose for L section this is right, the centroidal may be fall along this axis, right? So here will be, so in this L section, okay, this is my x axis and this is y axis. Okay, so these are the two principal central axes for this. See, for this section, if I fold along this x axis, then we won't get this as a symmetry, right? Even for the y axis, if I fold this like this, then you won't get. So means this L section has no symmetry about any axis, right? So now, so see, that for the I sections also it has double axis of symmetry, right? So if I fold this, I will get means double axis of symmetry, just showing, okay? So now, very important, this concept is only I am going to discuss for thin sections only. I will tell you later why I am going to discuss this for thin sections, not for thick sections, okay? So these are the sections, right? So see here you are applying the loads. These are the these sections have. Now I am going to in the previous slides we saw the sections, just these sections we saw, but here it is a beam, right, with the having length. So so these sections have double axis of symmetry. So at the center, at this point, if I apply the load here, right, so there will not be any bending, there will only pure bending, beam purely bends only, right? So in this case also, if I apply load at this center, the beam only loads. The same case here, right? So if I apply the load, then there will be bending only, not twisting. Now see here, it whenever load acts at G, okay, that is the center of gravity here, the beam section only bends, not twists. Here also the same, just now the previous slide I have put here, okay? Now see, suppose the cases in some places, so this load, whenever you act it at center of gravity G, passing through this center of gravity G, this P, it is called transverse loading. And suppose if I apply the eccentric transverse loading, this load is called, see, at this end, if I apply those, see, in the previous, if we apply the load passing through the center of gravity, the beam only purely bends. But if in this case, instead of applying the load here, if you apply the load eccentrically, right, which is not passing through the center of gravity, there is a twist, you will get some twisting, okay? This part will get twisted. So if you apply load at the offset from G, then member will be bent and twist also, right? So twist leads to more quick failure of the loaded. Twist lead to more quick failure of the loaded members than bending. So this concept is tells us the point of application of load, right? So what the shear center concept, where I have to apply the load exactly according to that sections, that thing the shear center will be tell us where to apply the load, so that there will not be any twisting in the member, only there is a bend, pure bending will be there. Yes, pure bending is acceptable, which is not that much severe, right, in order to keep design failure, okay? Now so that only possible to the twist, okay? We'll see now. So whenever load is passing through axis of symmetry, there is a pure bending, no twisting, right? So see here again. See, even though C sections, I put the C sections like this and I applied load along this axis, which is the axis of symmetry, right? This is not axis of symmetry. My application of the load is along the axis of symmetry, right? Here there will not be any twisting if you apply load. But the same, you inverted, and if you apply the load here, right, which is not axis of symmetry, there will be, you will get bending plus twisting, right? So this both thing you will get, right? Twisting means torsion, means there will be a part will be twist. Okay. Now this case is also what happening here. Just try to understand this concept. See here. In one case, see there is a the pin is like this. Okay. Here, if you apply the load here, there will be a twist. Right. So see here. If the load is applied far away from this, which is not at shear center, then the member twist like this anti-clockwise. Even you apply the shear, even you apply in this case, there will not be any twisting, only bending. So this point is called shear center. So you have to apply the load in such a way that there will not be twisting, only the pure bending. So here shear. Here there is again twisting. Okay, if you apply the load here, I think you understood till now. Okay, now we will see what the exactly this here, how to locate that point in unsymmetric sections. Okay, so in this class we will see for the C sections how to locate that. So here, see, this is a center of gravity, right? And I have applied a load along this, which is not axis of symmetry, right? This is what the axis of symmetry. If I apply load in this direction, there will be only bending. But this case is totally different, right? I am applying the load here, right? What I will do after application of this load, I will take one sections of dx. Okay, of very small thin sections, I will take out, and I will analyze this. How it looks like, okay? How the shear centers, shear comes, okay? Twisting means that there is a shear stresses are developed, right? That's why parts will twist. So to avoid that, okay? How first we will see how that shear center is coming, right? I have taken these sections, right, at a distance x from the point of application of the load, okay? I will see those. So see here. Now what is the bending moment at? See at AB, okay. What is the bending moment? That is bending moment at AB. AB means here. That is P into X. Okay, this applied load into X. This is a bending moment. At just let me. Right at this section AB. That is M AB is equal to P into X. Right. You know this bending moment. That is the distance application of the load. And perpendicular distance from that point means at this x, and for this I am considering the element that is the dx. Okay, so at bending moment at EF means at this section here, okay, px plus dx means bending as you going towards the fixed end on the beam or member, the bending moment is going to increasing, right? Here bending moment is not constant. Okay, so what is observing when I am moving from free end to fixed? Bending moment is varying linearly. This point is very important because here how there is a it is the head of the shear center comes out from this point, right? Because there is a varying in bending moment. So if there is a bending moment is varying, there will be definitely shear stresses, right? That's why. Okay, see, before going to that, we will see the complementary shear stresses, right? So if you try to rotate the part, okay, like this, right here, see, if you start to rotate the part like this, then there will be the shear stresses again. These are the to avoid or to rest that. Like this, shear stresses are developed. Okay, so this is called in order to resist that these stresses which are induced here. This is a complementary shear stresses, right? So this you already discussed in your strength of material, right? So no need to me explain more. Yes, here is the point. First, in the starting of the lecture, I already explained you why I am going to. Consider the thin sections only. This concept is for only thin sections, not thick sections. See where this type of sections are used in the trucks chassis, you might have seen, right? And they have applied the loads at a certain distance here. They have put on a bracket here like this, and the load application is here. This is what the shear center is. We will see that. Okay, for the thin sections, right? So not why it is not for thick sections. See, if I applied load at this point like this, right, it may be tension or compression, like bending stresses load are applied. See, at the top there is a fiber, at the bottom also there is a fiber. There will be stresses, shear stresses are present at the top and bottom. But in thick sections, in thin sections, okay, as thickness is very small, there will not be any shear stresses in these directions. Means, see, here in this direction there will be the shear stresses, right? So, but here there will not be any shear because see, this thickness is very small, right? So if I check the shear stresses in this direction, there will not be any shear stresses, right? So no shear stresses in this direction as member is very thin. But in this case, thick section, there will be shear stresses. This time you should have to consider this, right? So that's why we have taken it as a thin sections, right? Now see, I applied shear. Now we'll go to the our top main topic, that is shear center. See, this is my point of application of load, right? Here I have applied load. So this is my actually externally applying the load at this CG, right? So this is a CG, right? So which is passing through this center of gravity of this axis of this member sections. Okay, this I have applied the load. By application of this load, right, I will get, see, this is my neutral axis, right? Suppose this is x axis and this is y axis. So I apply my application of the load is on y axis, right? But the member on x plane, right, like this plane, there this is what the neutral axis, right? So the upper portion, all the fibers in the upper will be in tension, right? This is the neutral axis, and below neutral axis all the fiber are in compression. Sorry. So see here, this is what it looks like in tension, right? Because of, see here, I apply load vertically, but because bending these fibers, whatever these all the fibers above the neutral axis are in tension, and below this are in compression, right? So again here I have taken one sections out from this, right, dx at a distance x from the point of application load, and I will calculate the moment for this, right? So I request you all guys, please, I have written everything in the slide very clearly, okay? So just reading with the help of these slides, you will understand everything. Even though if you have any doubts, please ask, because this is a very interesting and important concept in the strength of material. There will not be asked any numerical questions on this in the gate exam, but yes, they will check whether the your concept clear or not. That thing they will check, right? So see, because of this point of application load, we will get this is a moment, right? Here you will get moment m, right? At this section here I am calculating now moment. See here, at the pre end there moment will be zero, right? But at a distance x from the point of application load, if I check a moment, there will be something moment m. And if I move towards this fixed end direction, then the moment will get the maximum moment is here at this end, right, where it is get fixed up. So at a certain distance x, again m plus dm, right? So there is a difference in bending moment, and you know from your basic strength of material topic that if there is a difference in bending moment, right, so there will be definitely shear stresses are exist, right? So So, okay, shear stresses are existing. We will see that how now. Now I want force. How? Okay, because of this, how the forces are coming? That thing, right? Shear forces, how coming? That thing we will see. See, we know the bending stresses, right? So m by I is equal to sigma by y, right? This is a basic bending moment, pure bending moment equations we already seen in our strength of material, right? Sigma. This deviation I won't tell you right now. You should study from that bending stresses, right? Topic in the strength of material. Okay, here y is the distance from the extreme fiber, means this. See, as this thickness is very small, right? So the y can take it from center, not a problem. Okay, so it is h by 2. Okay. So see here, this is from the front side, right? This is from the front side. Bending stresses will be sigma is equal to mi by h by 2. Okay, so at the back bending will be m plus tm, right? Means front shear. Just this is, I will consider this as a front and this will be the back. Okay, so at the back bending will be m plus dm, okay, which is increase the bending moment. Let me take my screen. Okay, so the net here, there will be the net force because of the difference in the bending moment. There will be a net force. See, if there is little difference in the bending moment, there will not be any net force. So if there is a difference, there will be the net force. So the net force will be, right? So dm h, right? H by 2 I s into t. What is s? I have considered one element at a certain distance from here. Okay, see here, this is s in this direction, this s and t, right? So this is a net force and this is the unbalanced force, and this I have to equate this unbalanced force, right, with this. Okay, see here, there, how these shear stresses are coming in this direction, you know. See here, let me tell you how these shear stresses I am going to compare with this bending stresses. Just think, I will clear. I know this is what the net force, right? So the net force in this force will be in this direction, right? This will be the in this direction, right? What is the, this is dm h into s, right? T divided by 2i. In this direction, there will be the net force, right? See, s means this much element I have considered, right? T is the thickness, and this thing you know, right? This is a net force in this direction, right? So in order to counterbalance this net force, which is in this direction, there will be shear stresses will be in this direction definitely. Otherwise, there will not be any equilibrium, right? So shear stresses has to develop in order to equilibrium, in order to counteract this net bending stresses, which is in this direction, right? So these are the stresses. So shear stress, that is tau dx, I have considered element like this ds, right, into t, this much thickness. I think, hope you understand. So I equate to them, then I will get dm by dx hs. What is dm by dx? Means there is any change in bending moment. Sorry, change in the bending moment, that is dm by dx, that is a shear force, right? Which is a shear force, means phi is a shear force. So tau is equal to vhs by 2i. So here, shear stress has directly proportional to S. Means S means where, suppose S is this much element I am considering, right, up to S. This is S. But shear stress is, sorry, direct, as you increases, the shear stresses are, see here we understood this, how this shear stress is coming like this, right? But to oppose this, there will be the shear stresses has to develop in this direction, right? How this comes? This comes because of this difference in the bending moment, right? So this line comes like this. The line means it's actually force, just I am telling you. But the part will rotate like this. Whether the part is rotating like this, it's no, right? So why it is not rotating? There will be the shear stresses in this direction are developing. That is what the complementary shear stresses, right? I hope you understand this, right? And the value of that shear stress, that varies linearly. So that's why I have taken like this. This will along this direction, the shear stress varying linearly. Okay, I think, see, in one time you won't understand this, you will not understand this very clearly. But I assure that you watch one more or you try to understand, watch this video again and again, then you will definitely get these concepts, right? So here, see, I apply application of the load at point P, the part will bend like this. So now, see, now the shear flow is varying, right? So here is small, again increasing, because just now we have seen shear stress is directly proportional to S, right, which is linear. So this will be the shear stress will be maximum at this point. Okay, now we understand the shear stresses, how it is varying linearly in the flange. Okay, so similarly here there is in against opposite directions, it is again changing shear. Okay, and we will watch it, we will see how the shear stresses are acting at this web area. Okay, this is, these are the flanges and this is a web for C sections. Okay, now there is a shear, there is a, because of this shear stresses, there is a, this force is in the direction, in this direction. Okay, this is for the front sides, but for back side, right, these forces are in opposite direction, right? At the end this will come in opposite direction, this it will change. So this will form the couple, the front is in clockwise and to in order to resist the fixed rein in opposite direction, right? So there will be couple formation of the couple. So now in the back end, please watch, read all whatever I have written here, because the written in this whatever I am writing, okay, very carefully and with lot of study I have written here. And even though from my explanation you won't understand, if you read everything, each and everything, you will get everything. Okay, so now shear flow, right, there will be a, see, because of this force in this direction and the force in this direction, which is equal and opposite, right, they are, the forces will cancel, but they are separate at a distance h by 2, right? So they will form a couple. Forces are getting cancelled, right? But the formation of the couple will take place. So in order to counterbalance this the force in this web area will, okay, what you applied here, this force, it will balance this, not a problem. Okay, but the only thing is that where this P, whether this P is here, you have to apply here or at a certain distance in order to counteract this, right, which is making a couple. One, you have to apply force at a such a distance at a E from this, so that this couple will get cancelled and there will not be any twisting in the part. So I have to equate this P into E, which is equal to F into H, right, this F into H, total distance, right? So this is what the shear center, right? So let me highlight this. This E is a shear center. So I have to apply at the point, okay, in such a way that this couple will get balanced and member will avoid twist, only bends, right? So this is what that shear center. I apply the load at a point distance, balance it completely by F and F, right? I try to explain very good as per my best, okay? Even though if you have any doubts, please put in the comments and tell me, so that I will try to explain more and more clearly about this shear center. This shear center is somewhat most critical concept. If you understand the bending stresses and shear stresses, right? So here the pinpoint is only the because of the difference bending moment, there is a shear center, there is a shear coming. Okay, shear stresses are developing, and to these are the forming couple, right? And to counteract or to balance that couple, right? To avoid twisting of the part, we have to apply load in a such a way that, right? So there will not be any couple formed by this. If you applied load here, there will not definitely there will be the couple like this, right? So see, this is these two forces are making couple which are separated at a distance, right? The force will get cancelled. There is no load on force, but because of this separation, this F and this F, right? There will be a formation of couple like this. So in order to avoid this making of the couple, you have to apply load at a distance. So most of the the chassis are like this, right? C sections made out from sections, and if you watch at chassis area, you will find that the load is applied at a certain distance. They will attach a bracket like this, right? See here, like this bracket attached, and load are applying at a certain distance so that there will not be any twisting like this. Okay guys, so I try to explain my best. If you are in doubt, please ask, put in the comments. Thanks for watching. Thank you. Bye.